Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. Thanks for tuning in today. This video is going to be pretty different from the ones I've done before. It's basically going to be a discussion video over something that I've really enjoyed over the past, I don't know, 3 or 4 months, I guess it's been around that time. And basically it's going to be a discussion of these two vinyl box sets. John Prine, the Atlantic Albums, and John Prine, the Asylum Albums. So basically, the reason I'm going to wanted to do this is just to kind of share my thoughts over the music and the quality of the box sets, and just why I like them and why they're so great that I chose to do a video about them. So, as far as I know, first of all, these are the only two box sets in this series. Now, the albums he did on Oh Boy Records, I don't know if he's going to do some sort of box set for that. I don't even know if all those albums have been formally released on vinyl either. So that's something that might happen in the future, and I'd probably end up making a video about it if that did happen. But just a little introduction, I haven't been a John Prine fan for very long. I started listening to him maybe a couple weeks after he died, which he died last year. And a lot of people were talking about him, and I had heard about him before. I had heard a few of his songs, but never really listened to his music to any kind of degree as a fan. But I soon would become quite a big fan. I decided to listen to his first album, I believe, after just kind of doing a little bit of research. And I'm gonna be honest, the first couple of listens was just kind of, I was just kind of taking in and absorbing everything that I was hearing. And then maybe on the third or fourth listen, I really was blown away and realized that this is one of the best albums I've ever heard and some of the best songwriting I've ever heard. So yeah, from there I kind of like went on to his other albums. I believe that before the first box set was released, which has his first four, I had known his first four albums pretty well, and this was released on Record Store Day, the August version of Record Store Day they had last year. And yeah, so immediately I fell in love with him after first listen. You know, his music, musically, his songs are simple yet very profound, and of course his lyrics are very praised in, you know, the vinyl community and just, you know, overall in the music community. All right, and I did find that his albums weren't the easiest to come by, so I was pretty excited being kind of like fresh on the John Prine wagon, to say that I was really excited to see this so that I could get all four of these albums for a decent price. I think this was, let me think, $80, I think, for four of them. So $20 a piece. And you know, this was a limited edition box set. They did release these separately after that. But honestly, this might be the most listened to item in my collection since I've got it. I think I've spun each of these records at least 3 times each. So probably shouldn't spend them that much, just since, you know, depreciates in value, but I just can't help it. So what I'm gonna do is show you what's inside here, because I haven't done that yet. And I'm going to kind of discuss, you know, the albums a little bit. It's not gonna be too in-depth, like an album review. But yeah, so this one, this box that I got, I think it was the first Record Store Day in August. I think that was the first one. So first of all, the packaging here is just the box, the Record Store Day sticker, nice picture of John here. On the side it says the Atlantic Albums with the little Atlantic logo there. And there's the box, here's the back. So you get all four of his albums, just the track listings and picture of John standing at some sort of food. Looks like a food truck or something. So the first album in here is his first self-titled album, which is pretty much legend at legend status. And yeah, so here it is. These ones come with a sleeve. I think it's called like a lined poly sleeve, some sort of anti-static thing, which is nice. Here's the record itself. Very nice. I think these are like pretty much exact reproductions, probably other than the sleeves, of the original albums, which is really cool. And it also comes with these little lyric sheets, which I'm not sure if these came in the original album, but it said exact packaging, so I assume that they did. Just a little bit about this album. This is probably my favorite of his. Just some songs. Probably, I'll try and pick maybe three favorites from each album. This one's gonna be hard. I'd probably pick right now Spanish Pipe Dream, Hello In There, and Donald and Lydia. Really like those. Every song on here is amazing. So definitely check out this album when you get the chance. Next up is Diamonds in the Rough, which is, in my opinion, his most underrated album that I've heard so far. It's amazing, not quite to the extent of his first, but it is nonetheless amazing. So here's the record. Same as the first one. It's the Atlantic label. I really like these labels too. It's really nice to watch these things spin. And you get the lyrics. This one is a lot more stripped back than the first one. I'm not sure if there are drums on any of these songs. Pretty much all acoustic guitar. There's a few songs with fiddle, you know, slide guitar and things like that. But it's very stripped back, kind of laid back. But nonetheless, this is lyrically amazing. Just as good lyrically as this album. A few of the songs here, especially the Torch Singer and the Late John Garfield Blues, are pretty much interchangeable, as in they sound very similar, but they're each lyrically very different. So that's kind of like his, kind of what sets him apart, you know. A lot of his songs might sound the same, but lyrically they are just so different that you can't you can immediately tell them apart. So my three favorites from this one would probably be, at the moment, Yes, I Guess They Ought to Name a Drink After You, The Great Compromise, and Rocky Mountain Time, probably. But again, every song on here I love. Every song on here is great. This is a great album. Just pull out your guitar. You can just play along, or just play each song by yourself, and it sounds, you know, it sounds good, it sounds natural. I mean, depending on who you are. I mean, I like to think that I sound okay when I play guitar, but what I'm trying to say is that it's a lot of fun to play these songs. His next album is called Sweet Revenge. And this might be my favorite album cover of his, just a really bad looking John Prine on the cover with a ciggy in his boots. And here's the back. And this is a great album too. Very great album. It's a lot different than his first two. It's a little bit more rock and roll inspired, not quite as country. And here's the album. Still very clean. And before I go any further, I gotta say that all of these albums sound impeccable. They sound amazing. And the guitar on here is just, the acoustic guitar sounds on all these albums are some of the best I've ever heard, especially on his first two. But yeah, here's a lyric sheet that comes with it. And also the vocals are mixed incredibly. And there is a CD box set called Crooked Piece of Time where you can get all seven of these albums in that box set, his first seven. And if you collect CDs, where I don't really collect CDs. But my three favorites on here would probably be Christmas in Prison, Grandpa Was a Carpenter, and The Accident, Things Could Be Worse. Those are my favorite songs on here, but honestly, every song on here is amazing, except 9 Pound Hammer, which is a cover, I'm pretty sure is subpar to the other songs, but it's still, you know, still a good song. It's a nice song to just kind of jam out to with the guitar. And the last album in this box set is Common Sense. And this, he kind of takes kind of a more polished direction with this album, which you can tell by both the production and kind of the musicianship, which I'll get into in a second. Let me show you real quick what is in here. Here's the album. Probably not much he's showing you every album because they're basically the same, as in the labels aren't different. But these things are cool. Here's another. What was it? Lyric sheet. And this is probably my least favorite of the four, but it's still very good. Still a very good album. Even might say a great album. Put it back in here real quick. But probably my three favorites off this one. I do love Wedding Day in Funeralville. That's a great song. Nice one to I love singing along to that song. It's just so much fun. Come on, get in there. All right, so first song I like is What Did I Just Say? Wedding Day in Funeralville. Way Down is great. And I like Forbidden Jimmy. And I also do like Come Back to Us, Barbara Lewis, Hare Krishna, Beauregard. And he does do a cover of Chuck Berry, You Never Can Tell, on this one, last song on here, which is worth a listen if you're a Chuck Berry fan. But anyway, that's all the albums in the first set. Let me get him back in here real quick. And yeah, these sets is basically just the cover and the albums. It's not really any other goodies in here, which I would have liked to have, but you know, it's still just the music alone and the quality of the music. It pays, you know, it's well worth what I paid for it. And just to have all these albums at my disposal in this one box was good, instead of having to go out and buy all of them separately. All right, next box set is the Asylum Albums. And right away, first of all, here's the back and the spine, the Asylum logo. This has the albums Bruised Orange, Pink Cadillac, and Storm Windows. And right away, packaging wise, these are different, which I'll get into in just a minute. Here's the first one, Bruised Orange. This is a 1978 album, which is probably my favorite packaged album out of all these sets, all the albums in these sets, and I'll show you. It just really looks nice inside, the orange. It just looks incredible. And these ones are different. They come with, they don't have a poly-lined sleeve, if I'm saying that correctly. It's just a regular paper sleeve. And the original inner sleeve, which is interesting. I don't know why they changed it. Maybe it was the different companies, is what I would guess. But yeah, that's a nice sleeve, and I'll show the record. These do have different labels. And I haven't replaced these sleeves yet, so there's a little bit of debris on it. I haven't listened to this set as much as the other one, but I have listened to each of these probably twice. And this album, I really love this album. I'd probably put this one above Common Sense if I were ranking them. And just a few of my favorites on here. Fish and Whistle is amazing. Bruised Orange, of course. Sabu Visits the Twin Cities Alone. And unpopular opinion, If You Don't Want My Love. I really love that song. I think it's a great song. It's just so simple and so great. The lyrics are a bit repetitive, but it just makes me feel a certain way. And songs that can do that, I really like. And also, That's the Way the World Goes Round is the big hit off here, and that's a great song as well. And this, let me say about this album, he uses a flute on here a lot, and it sounds really good. It's a good new direction. In each of these albums, he takes sort of a different direction, which I really respect. Like, his first album was kind of straight country, kind of Americana country. Then he goes kind of more in maybe a bluegrass Americana on his second one. Then his third album kind of goes more rock and roll. And then his fourth kind of goes more contemporary country pop. And then this one, I don't know what I would call this. It's still polished, but it's still kind of stripped back a little bit. And also there's some saxophone and flute in there, which he didn't put at all in his first four albums. So enough about Bruised Orange. This is Pink Cadillac from 1979. Here's back. And here is the record. With the Asylum label. And the original inner sleeves. Having fun on the back there. This album is probably my least favorite out of all of these. But you can tell he's having a lot of fun recording this album. And even in the liner notes in here, it says that Jay just kind of jammed out in a room and kind of picked. They had so many songs and just picked the ones they liked the most. So I'm glad that, he enjoyed it a lot. I still enjoy this album. I don't think it's as good as the other ones. And this thing is not one to go in. There we go. Well, anyway, three songs I like off here are my three favorites. I like them all pretty much. I like Chinatown, the first one. I like Down by the Side of the Road is really good. And probably How Lucky would be my third favorite. Again, this is it's an okay album. It's pretty good. It's not my favorite. But, it's John Prine, and I love John Prine, so I'm gonna listen to it. And the last album in these sets, and in case you were wondering, here's the hype sticker from the Asylum Albums box set. It says, "The Mark Twain of American Songwriting." Rolling Stone magazine. That's what they called him, I guess. Which I would agree with that, probably. But the first one did not come, I don't think the first one, it came sealed but without a hype sticker. But this one did come with a hype sticker. And the Record Store Day sticker. So the last one is Storm Windows, which is a very enjoyable listen for me. And let me just show you the record and everything real quick. It's the same as all the other ones with the Asylum label. And these sound great as well. I've heard that some people had problems with Pink Cadillac and that was skipping all over the place, but I have no problems with it. So they must have just gotten faulty pressings. And here's the original inner sleeves. Nice. I really like this album. This is kind of, the direction he takes on here is similar to Pink Cadillac, but not quite as simple. I think the songwriting on here is better. Man, I'm having trouble getting these scenes back in. What I gotta do is put the record in and then put the inner sleeve. My three favorites on this one is probably It's Happening to You, definitely. That's a great song. Storm Windows is great, and All Night Blue is a really good song I like. And this inner sleeve is still acting up. Come on. Alright, there we go. So there you go, Storm Windows. And that's it for this, you know, overview of the box sets. In conclusion, even though I've only been listening to his music for, let's say, maybe 7 or 8 months, 9 months, whatever it is, he has really impacted just my sense of humor, my songwriting, my guitar playing, pretty much everything. He's really, like, impacted me in a big way. And yeah, it's sad that, you know, we lost him last year, but at least he left us some really amazing music. And I have eclipsed these albums and got onto his later ones, so I don't know if I'll be talking about any of those, but I'm going through his entire discography, and I'll probably talk about that sometime in the future, especially if he releases another vinyl box set. I will be first in line to get that thing. It really doesn't matter how much they make me pay, honestly. Just love the guy so much. He's great, amazing, and I don't know if it'll be a Record Store Day release, but let's hope so this coming year, Record Store Day. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and any thoughts you might have on John Prine, or if you have these box sets, any thoughts on them, or your favorite John Prine album or song, just you know, comment. I love to talk to you guys. And yeah, thanks guys for watching this video, and if you have any suggestions for future videos that you'd like to, maybe you'd like to see my thoughts on, or like album reviews or anything, you need to do another album review, just, you know, leave a comment. And yeah, thanks you guys for watching, and I hope you guys have a great day or night or wherever you are. And yeah, God bless.